Hey guys, so today I'm going to be reviewing the John Frieda Luxurious Volume Visibly Full and Touchably Soft Shampoo and Conditioner. I guess it's just touchably full shampoo and conditioner, but I read the whole thing. Anyways, they come in tubes like these, which I actually like because you have more control on how much product you can squeeze out versus the kind that you kind of just pour out. The shampoo is just a clear consistency while the conditioner is like a milky white, which is pretty typical. The shampoo claims that it gently cleanses for volume that looks and feels natural, and the conditioner claims that it weightlessly detangles for volume that looks and feels natural, and they both say they transform fine hair. So I got these several months ago when I went on a very successful couponing trip to CVS. Now, if you don't follow me on Instagram and you're into couponing, you definitely should, because whenever I go couponing on there, I will take a picture of my haul and break down exactly how and where I got those deals. So if you want deals on shampoos like this that I can't usually afford either, then go check out my Instagram. Okay, now that I'm done pimping out my Instagram, let's talk more about the shampoo and conditioner. So of course there's more in the line than the shampoo and conditioner, so it's one of those where I'm sure if you use every single product that the line has to offer that you will get the best effects of what they're trying to offer you. However, when I picked these up, I was expecting that these would feel super luxurious because they're high end and it would really make my hair be fuller and, I don't know, just better, I guess. Well, I was kind of disappointed. And again, this could be kind of based on my hair type as well. That's why, you know, things like these reviews are subjective. It depends on you. So my experience with the shampoo and conditioner is that you don't need a lot of product to feel like you're getting a good cleanse and a good moisturization, which is good. So I'll use a little shampoo and do where I usually scrub at the scalp and then scrub all the way down and then rinse, and then I will use the conditioner only in the second half of my hair because I don't want this to get too oily. Although I'm doing that, the problem I'm finding is I'm still getting oily on my scalp, more so than I have with any other hair products like this that I've tried. So that leads me to believe it's the shampoo. Now, I'm using similar amounts to what I would use with other shampoos and conditioners. I'm using the same products otherwise, you know, like deep conditioners and oils and stuff that I was using before I started these. And so it's weird because I will go in the shower with dirty hair, think I'm really cleansing it. The next day, it's not immediately, but the next day I'll just feel stiff and oily more than normal in my scalp. And I don't like that. It makes my hair feel dirtier than when I was going in to wash it, because obviously I do the dry shampoo like every other day or somewhere around that. But it makes it so I feel like my hair's weighted down, which makes no sense because it's saying how it's like touchably soft and light and fluffy and all that stuff. So it feels weighted down and it feels dirtier. And it's not even like I used a lot of it. And it's just, that's not what I was expecting to come from a product like this. The conditioner, I think, is fine. The conditioner is a perfectly fine conditioner. It moisturizes my hair enough and feels nice. I really think the shampoo is the thing that I'm having an issue with, just because, like I said, I'll do exactly what I do, but it's somehow making me feel even less clean. And, I mean, I still have a good amount left in these. I'm still going to use them because then I could just, you know, kind of touch up with dry shampoo or something, or put it in a ponytail and then I feel okay. But that just kind of was a letdown that I was excited to finally try like high-end hair products, and that's what ends up happening. So that's my experience with these. They retail for $6.99 each at CVS, which is where I bought them. However, if you're looking for them more affordable, I'm seeing Target has them for $5.49 each. I mean, drugstores are always going to be pricier, but at the time it was even a better deal because, again, I was couponing. So that's all I really have to say about these. Okay, not the best, and I won't be repurchasing just because these are not working for me. Let me know if you guys have tried anything like this and what your experiences are. I want to know if I'm the only one this is happening to, or if it's the shampoo or if it's the hair type. So I look forward to your comments. So hope you guys enjoyed this video. Don't forget to, and I will see you in my next one. Bye.